Student, very good morning to all of you. So as I circulated that today's lecture is on how to crack GPAT 2021. It is a very important lecture. So today's expert is Kastub Pawar. So Kastub basically currently working as a research executive trainee in pharma research, especially formulation and development department at Lupin Limited. So if I'll give you a brief background of the Kastub and his achievements. So Kastub completed B.Pharm from Maharashtra Institute of Pharmacy, Savitribai Phule, Pune University in 2018. He has completed M.Pharm from Pharmaceutics branch from ICT Mumbai in 2020. So if I inform you various major achievements of the Kastub. So Kastub secured All India ranked second in GPAT 2018 examinations. He ranked amongst top five students throughout the B.Pharm at Savitribai Phule Pune University. He was a first ranker in all of the years of the B.Pharm from his college. He has honored Best Ongoing Student Award by Maharashtra Institute of Pharmacy, Pune. He has completed industry project at Ferring Pharmaceutical, Thane. He worked as a joint secretary in IPA, that is called Indian Pharmaceutical Associations, Pune branch. One of the great initiative of the Kastub, so he has an Instagram page called Pharmascopy, where can say it's a online education platform for the GPAT aspirant, where he is daily posting very important notes as well as the video on Pharmascopy. He has also his own YouTube channel named Pharmascopy. He has worked as a honorary faculty at Pharma Elite GPAT coaching classes, Thane, Mumbai. He has also secured All India rank first in MIBO GPAT mock test 2018. So MIBO is basically a South-based organization which are conducting the mock GPAT examination every year. And he has secured many awards in paper presentation competitions. He has also won second prize in food quiz competition during 56th National Pharmaceutical Celebrations. So with this background, I invite Kastub Pawar for delivering the talk. And on behalf of Ramanbhai Patel College of Pharmacy and Charusati University, I am thankful to Kastub for accepting our invitations and ready to deliver a talk to GPAT aspirant of our university. So thank you, Kastub, and now it's over to you.
Hello, sir.
Yes.
Yeah. Is slide visible?
Just one second.
Yes, sir.
Yes,
sir. Yes, it's visible. No?
Yes.
Yes. So we will begin. So first of all, thank you, Umang Shah sir, as well as Ramanbhai Patel College of Pharmacy, for inviting me, and thank you for such a wonderful introduction. I'm honored to be at your college and deliver this session. So as sir has told, so this session will be on how to crack GPAT 2021. As we all know, GPAT is a entrance exam which we have to qualify to get M.Pharm admission in across the India. So we will start with our session. So first of all, before knowing how to do it, like how to crack GPAT or how to study or how to make notes, first of all, it's very important for us students to know why do we want to do it. Why do you want to take so much efforts to crack or to get an All India rank or whatever your goal might be? So for me, based upon my experience, I will tell, when I started my preparation in third year, my purpose was to gain as much as knowledge and the skills which I can get throughout my B.Pharm or throughout my preparation of GPAT. And to be an excellent at what I do, so to be excellent in my preparations, to be excellent in the knowledge which I gain, because whenever I will be excellent, success to aana hi hai, as Rancho has said in Three Idiots, excellence ke piche bhago, सक्सेस तुम्हारे पीछे आएगा. सो दैट वॉज माई पर्पज. सो आफ्टर नोइंग द पर्पज, वाई डू यू वॉन्ट टू डू इट, यू शुड फिक्स योर टारगेट और गोल फॉर योर जी पैट. लाइक इन माई जी पैट 2018 व्हेन आई क्वालिफाइड इट, माई टारगेट वॉज टू गेट ऑल इंडिया रैंक. So sorry, my target was different. Rather than getting an All India rank, I will tell you ahead. So you have to decide whether you want to get an All India rank or you just want to qualify, because that mindset will determine how much efforts you will put in this coming months. So my goal actually was to score above 300. Now why it is so? Because when I was preparing for my GPAT 2018, I did one survey. So till GPAT 2017, jitne bhi rankers the, so every ranker had a score around 260-250. So I decided that my target will be to score above 300. So it means it will be a record itself. And if I do so, then I will be eventually among top three. So that's why my philosophy always, I say that aim for a gold, then you will land up with the silver. And to get gold, you have to aim for the world record. That's why my aim was to get score above 300. And with the God's grace, I was able to score 318, which still stands the second highest score in GPAT history. So this was my why. This was my motivation to persist throughout this journey for cracking the GPAT and for getting an All India rank. So now let's begin with the core content. So as we all know, we have seen the syllabus of GPAT. So we have around 20 subjects for GPAT. And apart from GPAT, there are various other entrance exams, like for Manipal, they have their own exam, WITS, JSS, Bharti Vidyapeeth. Syllabus remains the same as that of GPAT. Only after you qualify GPAT, if you want to pursue your master's in NIPER, you have to qualify NIPER entrance exam. So for that, they have just added 2 to 3 parameters like mental aptitude and farmer general knowledge along with our GPAT syllabus. So main content, main focus is the same, that we have 20 subjects which we have to study, which we have to gain knowledge, and we have to score a good marks. So here there is a key point, because as we all know, 20 subjects, like from first year of our BPharm to the last year of your BPharm last semester, we have to study each and every subject. It's difficult but not impossible. So what I decided, and what you can do also, be master of most rather than being jack of all. Means that it's better, first of all, to be thorough with all the 20 subjects, but it's tough. So start with few subjects which you have a strong hold, and then slowly, slowly go on increasing your subjects and become master of the most. So that technique you can use. Rather than focusing ki apne ko pure 20 ke 20 subjects lene hai, 20 ke 20 subjects study karne hai. So rather than start chunk by chunk and then complete each and every subject topic from the GPAT syllabus. So this was like how you should start with the syllabus. Now this slide says, I have just mentioned the subjects. I have categorized it according to the basic subjects, which are also called as the minor subjects, and major subjects, which have most of the questions in GPAT. And there are a few allied subjects also. So whenever you start preparing for GPAT, now like in this, we have students from third semester also. So your goal will be in GPAT 23 or 22, and as well as final year students who have goal with a GPAT 21. So whenever you will start for your preparation, start with basics. And it's most important, because whenever our foundation will be strong, then only our building will be strong. Because if you see the physical chemistry, physical pharmacy, or dispensing pharmacy, microbiology, these all has the basic concepts. Upon that concepts, the major sub are designed, like pharmaceutics, biopharmaceutics, then like coology has the basics in pathophysiology, HAP. So if you don't know the human anatomy and the disease, how it will be possible to know the actual drug and actually its mechanism of action? That's why everything in pharmacy is correlated with one another. So that's why I always start with basics like microbiology, pharmaceutical engineering, those subjects which you are studying in first, first four semesters. We will take it as a semester pattern. So for first four semester, whenever you will start, finish it in a couple of months, then move to major subjects. And whenever you will start with major subjects, have a touch with the basic subjects. So whenever you will learn pharmaceutics, whenever there will be chapter of emulsions, suspensions, as its basics in colloids, I will tell you in ahead slides, like how you should correlate with the basic chapters. So at that time, just go and revise those pharmaceutical, physical pharmacy subjects whenever you will do pharmaceutics. Similarly, whenever you will start reading pharmacology, medicinal chemistry, just go back for a couple of weeks and revise the basics of organic chemistry, basics of physical chemistry, so that it will be very easy to understand the concepts of our major subject. This may say bahut sare questions aate. And then at the end, you can focus on our allied subjects, which are jurisprudence, management, which you can cover up easily. So this is the entire syllabus for a GPAT. Now, how you should actually prepare and start preparing. So whenever you will start, as I have mentioned in this slide, you should start step by step. Like I was saying in previous slide, start with basics. And here are a few examples how actually you should study. Whenever you will start studying medicinal chemistry or our chemistry part, you should first get thorough with heterocyclic name reaction synthesis, because these heterocyclic name reaction synthesis, which we will study in organic chemistry, based on that only our medicinal chemistry structures, structural activity relationships and synthesis are designed. So it's better to understand the basics and so that we can understand the medicinal chemistry structure. Now, for example, if we have a TB anti-TB drug, isoniazid, take an example. So isoniazid ka structure apne ko yaad rakhna. So if a question comes, how will be the question in GPAT, we will see. So the concept is of isoniazid. So question will be like this, identify which of the following heterocyclic ring is present in isoniazid. So like this questions will be asked and there will be four options, four different heterocyclic ring. So if we want to remember the structure of isoniazid, we have to know the heterocyclic chemistry, know the nomenclature, know the naming systems of the so therefore the answer will be pyridine is the basic component of isoniazid. Similarly, if it is in pyrazinamide, which is anti-TB drug, it should contain, as the name itself says, pyrazine moiety, that is a pyrazine heterocyclic ring. So similarly, now if you want to study structural activity relationship in medicinal chemistry, it's one of the most important concepts or topics from which the questions come in GPAT or any other competitive exam. So the questions will be like, which of the following functional group will enhance the activity of this drug? We will take a penicillin example. So for that, you have to know the functional groups first of all. Then for synthesis of medicinal chemistry, each and every synthesis of a medicinal drug is based upon only 3 to 4 core functional group ka jo synthesis hai, like for carboxylic acid synthesis, OH group synthesis, aldehyde group synthesis, amine group synthesis, because these all functional groups are present in our medicinal chemistry drug. If you know those basic synthesis, it will be easy to understand the entire synthesis process of our example of penicillin or any other drug. So like this, you have to study. Then we will take another example for coology. So like coology, it is interdependent. So for knowing the mechanism of action of, say, tetracycline, you have to know first disease, which microorganism is involved, or if to know the diuretic, how is the pathophysiology. If you want to know the diabetes, anti-diabetic like insulin, you have to know first pathophysiology of diabetes, how it actually occurs, what is the source, and then it will be easy to know the mechanism of action of insulin as well as other oral hypoglycemic drugs like metformin. And when you will be thorough with the concepts of coology, it will be easy to know the drug of choice, means drug of choice or ADR, which are adverse drug reactions, from which at least couple questions are there from GPAT. So like this, you have to link from starting from our basics to the subjects of pharmacy. Similarly, in example of SUTICS, as I have already mentioned, colloids, in which we study surfactants and types of surfactants, HLB scale, then how to calculate HLB, all our physical pharmacy subject ka chapters, so that we study in first 4 semesters mein ho jata. So that you have to correlate with the actual formulation, which is being SUTICS, novel drug delivery, emulsion. So if you want to design a liposome, You have to know which surfactant you have to use, or if you want to design an OBW emulsion, if a question comes in a GPAT, which of the following surfactant will you use in OBW emulsion? You have to know whether you want to use a twin or a span. So for that, you have to be go through and you have to have a basic understanding of the physical pharmacy surfactant chapter. So like this, you have to study step by step. Similarly, one of the last example which I always tell, biopharm, which is one of the most important subject in your future also, or you will work in a industry. As biopharm, you have to know the compartment models, or you have to know, you have to calculate what will be the distribution, what will be the clearance, what will be the T half life. So all these concepts are being like laid down in the basic subjects, like for kinetics, which we see in physical pharmacy, physical chemistry. First order reaction, second order reaction, calculate their T half life. So that concepts will be applicable in the biopharmaceutics whenever a drug goes a first order reaction or whenever a drug undergoes a second order reaction. So that similar kinetics is being taught in physical chemistry. Similar, if you want to the compartment models, like for example parenterals, so or injections, that injectables. So injectables under which compartment model, whether they go in open compartment or a closed compartment, first order or second order. To know that concept, you have to know the basic dosage form, what actually parenterals or injectables are, and what will be the ADME, that is absorption, distribution, and elimination from pathology. So like this, you have to study step by step. So this is applicable in every subject of our GPAT syllabus. And this is the key actually to crack any GPAT 2020, any GPAT or any other competitive exam. Then next most important topic from a GPAT preparation, like every time whenever I deliver session, students always ask me how we should get time. So I have made a separate slide on that. So usually we have a 24 hour, sabko 24 hours hi rehta hai. So from that, as we all know, students ko bahut, it's a joke, but if we have an 8 to 9 hours of college, and apart from that, you will get a 5 hours free time. So on that 5 hours free time, you can just 2 to 3 hours for daily preparation. It's more efficient. I have also allotted, like whenever I used to prepare for my GPAT, I used to just study for 2 to 3 hours, but it was a daily preparation habit for preparing. You have to study daily, so that you can cover each and every topic from this 20 subjects. Many of the time students study for 1 or 2 days for 8 to 9 hours, and remaining of 5 days they just waste. So rather than wasting, invest your 2 to 3 hours every day. And for distribution, okay, how much weeks you should study for a subject. So usually a minor subject like physical pharmacy, microbiology, organic chemistry, covered in 1 to 2 weeks. So you have to know ki how much time you have to invest in a subject, because most of the time students make mistakes that they spend lots of time in minor subjects and they have much less time for our major subjects. So that's why just allot to 1 to 2 weeks. In that 1 to 2 weeks, it's more than sufficient to cover a minor subject. To cover the entire subject, for example physical pharmacy, in 1 to 2 weeks, all you have to know what exactly you want to study, what are, that I will cover up in further slides. So that is important, and how to know what are the important points to cover up in a specific subject. And for major subject, you can cover it in 3 to 4 weeks, like in 1 month period, major subject for a GPAT can be completed. So keep this record and keep this track, see how much weeks you are investing in a single subject. So this was general a flow chart for a time management. Then moving ahead, how to prepare. So this was the technique which I used to prepare, and I always recommend this technique to my fellow students, because this has helped me a lot. So when I used to study, I used to take a topic. So for example, if you take a colloid topic from physical, I used to study it. Then that the second line is important, don't and try to understand, like every teacher tells his student to understand the concept, and it's true. In GPAT, you cannot qualify, you cannot get an All India rank without understanding the concepts. Because in GPAT or any other competitive exams, question will be applied. They won't be a straightforward question like in our semester exams of our universities. Universities, we have a habit to write a lengthy question and it will be a theoretical stuff. But in GPAT, it will be an applied question. So for applied, you have to know actual concept. Kya hai wo cheez? So for that, study, try to understand, try to imagine that concept. After understanding, if you want to get sure you have understood that concept, go and discuss with your friends and explain those concepts. So I used to start explaining those concepts to my fellow friends. And when I used to explain that concept, apne bhasha mein, like making it, I used to, that had that helped me to remember those concepts. So if we take an analogy in here, so in microbiology, we have difference like gram staining, acid staining. So in staining technique, we need a modern. Modern means jo apna stain hai, that fixate in our cells, jo gram cells hai. So like in gram staining, we use potassium iodide and iodine mixture as a gram staining modern. So when you will explain those concepts, it will act as a fixating agent for those concepts in your mind. So always try to explain those concepts. And the most important, which I have highlighted, solve the questions, because practice is essential. Practice makes man perfect, and it's true. When my preparation, I solved around 2000 questions of every subject from different books. So we have 4 to 5 different books like Inamdar, Pearson from by our sir Umang Shah, then Muhammad Ali Bush, and various test series which you can get hand on. So solve as much as questions you can, because whenever you will solve questions, you will know how questions are formed, what will be the correct answer. And one more extra thing important, I will cover up in next slides. It is essential to solve the previous year question papers. Then this was the general overall technique which you can use to study for your GPAT preparations. Then starting with notes. So it is the most important question in every student's mind, whether should we take notes, whether should we make notes, or we should refer our books. So it varies person to person. Few students like to read books, few students like to make notes. But I highly recommend you should take notes while studying, because whenever it will be a time of revision, like in month of December, the last month, November or December, whenever you want to revise, at that time it's difficult to go back and read entire book. For example, Cohology, it will be difficult to read KD Tripathi in a single go. So at that time, whenever you will have your handwritten notes, your own notes, it will be easy to revise, because aapko pata hai ki aapne kya likha hai and kahan kya likha hai. So you will require less time to revise the entire subject. And in notes, how to take notes, a key, and it's a skill for GPAT or any other competitive exam, to make notes of only bulletin points or important points, unlike our GPAT preparation. So in couple of slides, I will explain you how actually you should take notes. Oh, actually you should prepare notes. So during my preparation, I have this whiteboard, and I used to take notes on that whiteboard. So this is the few slides, a few couple of photos which I got during my preparing this session. So you can see in this first figure, I have mentioned all the heterocyclic synthesis name reactions, like Palnor synthesis, Dahl-Fischer-Indol reaction. Then for pyridine, what are the actual name reactions for a specific? Because in organic chemistry, we have to know different name reactions. So in this, while preparing a name reaction note, you have to make notes of only three things. First, what is the reactant? Second, what is the catalyst? And third, what will be the end product? So only these three things are important from a GPAT perspective or any other competitive exam, because the question will be like this. Identify the following name reaction. They will give the name, the reaction, and you have to identify which they will give the names as in the option, and you have to just correlate which of the following is the name reaction. Or else another type question will be, they will give the starting materials, catalyst, and you have to identify the end product. So to know that, you have to just make notes likewise, reactant, catalyst, product. So if you make notes on a single sheet, and if you start revising and start practicing it, you can easily get thorough with the name reactions or any organic chemistry subject or topic. Then moving to next figure, in the next figure on the right hand side, excuse me. In this, I have just highlighted mentioned all the important formulas from biopharmaceutics. As in biopharmaceutics, there will be questions from calculations like how to calculate volume of distribution for following some, calculate T half-life for following, calculate clearance rate. So likewise, questions will be there from biopharmaceutics. So in this one single page, one single slide, I have enlisted all the important biopharmaceutical formula so that whenever I used to revise in single go, it was possible to cover and revise all the important formulas. Then moving to in this slide, I have made notes, I have put notes of analysis as well as cognoscence. So like in analysis, it's like key point and important point to know the IR ranges and NMR ranges. Every year they will ask at least either IR values for a specific functional group or either NMR values for a specific functional group. So if you just for a spectroscopy, you can read the most ideal book to learn spectroscopy and to know the values. The values are enlisted like in a tabular, so it's difficult to know. So for that, I devised this text. So you can make a line graph and you can put a compartments like for 350 value, uske baad 330 ka value, then 300, 220, 180. So likewise, you can make a line chart and which of the following functional group, jo bhi rahenga, in those IR ranges, just mention that. So in a single sheet of paper, in a graphical abstract, it will be easy to know the IR values. So whenever you will make notes in a flow chart or make notes in a graphical abstract point of view. So that whenever you will see those notes, it will be easy to recollect those concepts. Similarly, for pharmacognosy, it's a theoretical subject, we all know. And it's a little bit dry subject, but we have to study because at least 10 to 12 questions will be there from pharmacognosy. So what you can do for pharmacognosy? In this slide, I have enlisted the notes for our stomata. Like in stomata, we have 5 different stomatas and we have to know the pharmacognostic which are. So you can make a tabular form in a table. You can, in a first column, note down the parasitic, anisocytic, the type of stomata, and in next column can note down the drug. So in a go, you just correlate. कि सेना में एटिक स्टोमाटा है, पेपरमिंट में डायसेटिक स्टोमाटा है, लाइकवाइज. सो लाइकवाइज आई विल रिकमेंड यू शुड स्टार्ट मेकिंग नोट्स फॉर योर प्रिपरेशन. देन दिस इज अनदर एग्जांपल संडे ऑनलाइन सेशंस वेयर आई टीच एंड वेयर आई गाइड द स्टूडेंट्स फॉर हाउ यू शुड क्रैक, हाउ यू शुड स्टडी एंड एजुकेट देम अबाउट द फार्मेसी एंड डिफरेंट सब. सो इन मेंशन द ग्लास पैकिंग का एंटायर ग्लास पैकिंग टाइप्स slide. So like this, you can make a table. You can correlate type 1 glass with type 2, type 3, type 4. This is an example for you. Like this, you can own. So in this single figure, I'm able to revise the type or the name of type 1, that is a neutral borosilicate. Similarly for type 2, soda lime silica, regular silica, type 4, which is a non-parental. Then what is actual concept, that is type 1 or highly hydrolytic, which I have highlighted in this slide, and in then the last row which states the use or the purpose of that glass packaging material. So likewise, in an entire single column or one single able to revise the whole subject. So start making notes like this. Then move to the tricks and mnemonic part. So it's one of the, like we can say, handy tool for you to crack your GPAT or your NIPER or any other competitive exam. So this is the example from my Pharmascope Instagram page where I put post the various notes and the mnemonics and tricks for GPAT perspective. So in the first figure, as you see, I have mentioned the mnemonic for tetracycline. It's ADR toxicity. So the mnemonics is a copulative name which has been correlated with the ADR of the tetracycline. Like K stands for kidney failure, A stands for anabolic effect, P stands for photosensitivity. Likewise, every letter stands for a specific ADR. So whenever there will be a question on tetracycline, if you are able to recollect the mnemonic Kapildev, you will be able to accurately pinpoint what will be the correct answer and you will get your +4 marks. So likewise, revise your own mnemonics, own tricks to remember the theoretical topics or jo bhi theoretical concepts for like cognacy, then ADR or any other theoretical subject. So make mnemonics so that it will be easy for you to remember. Then the second figure in this, I have listed the various drug of choices for various seizures. Like I have enlisted the seizure types, absence seizure, myoclonic seizure, and just in front of that, the various drug of choice. So as the there are various questions for drug of choices also in GPAT, at least one question every year they try to ask. So likewise, you can make your own drug of choice, or in various books, they have given the list for the various drug of choices, which you can follow. Then moving to the next step, which is how to prepare and correlate. So this is the key point and the basic to crack any competition or to get score in your semesters also, or to understand actually what pharmaceutical subjects or what is the content in it, which it will help in your future also whenever you will join your industry or whatever your goal might be. So when I will always recommend you study similar topics together and correlate various topics. Our pharmaceutical jo bhi apna syllabus design kiya hai from, not like engineering any other stream. In engineering, we have various disciplines like mechanical ka alag, electrical ka alag. But in pharmacy, all the disciplines are together and taught in a single umbrella, which is of B-Pharm. Like in the pharmaceutics also, we can study cognacy also, analysis also, ecology also. In masters, that they go separately, but in B, we have to study different disciplines together. So that your key point is you have to correlate the topics from interdisciplinary. Like sutics ka jo topic hai, uska application aur uska basis is in medicinal chemistry or ecology. Pharmaceutical jo dosage form hai, that is eventually gonna be evaluated and which is being taught basis. UVRA, that will be used as analytical technique to identify the drug which is being taught in medicinal chemistry. This is the technique which you should adapt in to know how you can correlate various subjects, various topics from different mainstream subjects and understand the actual concept and actual applications. For example, from PP, suspensions from sutics and dispensing pharmacy, every these are the various topics from the subjects different in your GPATs which you can study. For then next example, carbohydrate amino acids. These two topics are mentioned in organic chemistry also, in our biochemistry also, in our cognacy also. So whenever you will study these topics, you can study these two topics from organic chemistry, cognacy in a single. So you will be able to complete various subjects time, and you will require less time to prepare. Then similarly, for ecology, medicinal chemistry, it's utmost important that you should study them together, because both in a single drug, we have its pharmacological action also, and we have know its structural activity relationship also for the same drug. So it's essential and it's important that you start studying both these together. While studying, start with ecology, know its mechanism of action, know its ADME, know its use, and then start reading its structural activity relationship as well as synthesis, so that the single topic can be covered from both the syllabus, ecology as well as medicinal chemistry, so along with the pharmacy topics. So for example, so this is one of my which I have uploaded on my YouTube channel, Pharmascope. In this session, I have covered up various subjects, various topics from various different types. Like as you can see in this slide, the local anesthetic topic, which is a part of pharmacology and medical chemistry, I have correlated section, because as we all know, local anesthetics, ideally they are administered through parenteral route. So it's better to know the application of the pharmacology, medicinal chemistry ka drug, local anesthetic, and that's why I have co-linked with the injectable part, injection. So you are able to understand the actual concept of injections and its basis of local anesthetics. Now, local anesthetics mechanism of action, in when you will start reading local anesthetics, when you will start understanding its mechanism of action, it is dependent upon which is dissociation constant. Now, for dissociation constant, that is present in the percentations topic in biopharmaceutical syllabus. So you are correlating the cology, medicinal mechanism of action of local anesthetic, with the percent ionization of biopharmaceutics. So you are reading interdisciplinary, and it will be easy for you to understand the actual concept. If you'll just read mechanism of action of pharmacology, apne ko entire concept jo hai and uska application, we might not be able to understand. But if you'll correlate with different topics from subjects, easy to understand these concepts. Similarly, I've included the analysis of FTR of carbonyl compound in the same session. And why? Because as we all know, local anesthetics have two different class in medicine chemistry classification, amide class and ester class. How we will identify amide and ester? So for that, we have a spectroscopic technique called as FTR or IR spectroscopy. In IR, we can know we have different peaks for amide group, different peaks for ester group, so that you can, if learning like this, ester is correlated with the FTR of analysis. So in a single go, you are able to cover FTR part also in a single session. So similarly, drug of choice ADR, which is a further industrial application or real life application of local anesthetics, that for which disease or which state you have to use the lidocaine, for which state you have to use the bupivacaine, that is a drug of choice of the specific local, or if we use lidocaine, what will be the adverse drug reactions for that lidocaine. So these two parts are present in the clinical pharmacy subject. So likewise, and I have mentioned liposomes from pharmaceutics. Now why it is so? Because currently science are trying to develop prolonged local anesthetic dosage form, so that there won't be induced local anesthetic frequently, and we will have a more patient compliance, and that's why we are trying to make liposome. So like, if you are able to correlate various subjects, various topics from interdisciplinary subjects, you are able to cover the entire subject, entire syllabus from GPAT perspective, as well as you understand the act and its industrial applications, which will in your future. So make a habit. Similarly, there is another where I have tried to correlate clinical trial, which is a part of pharmacology, clinical pharmacy, its applications. Why do you want to do clinical trials? Then there are different types of patients, which is part of biopharmaceutical syllabus. So if you'll see the GPAT syllabus in biopharmaceutics, there is a topic of new drug applications, generic drugs, bioequivalence. So these can be related to clinical trials, because these are applications for which we do the clinical trials, like new drug action. Jabhi bhi new drug aata hai market mein, that has to go through clinical trials. So likewise, you can correlate. And for ANDA, that is bioequivalence, for generic drug, we don't do clinical trials, we do bioequivalence study. Likewise, you have to study interdisciplinary. So this is the actual phenomenon which helped me to surpass and to achieve my GPAT target, as well as it is helping me throughout my industrial, as well as it have helped me throughout my masters. So make a habit of studies and learning. So moving to now we have completed how, so we have seen various topics, how to make notes, how to make mnemonics, tricks, how you should study, how you should correlate topics. Now we will come to the second last part, which is what to study. Now this is the important point, ki apne ko kya study karna hai, which topics are important, that we know. So hard working is essential, but along with that, you should study smart. You should know, and you should study important bulletin points and concepts for cracking any GPAT. So I listed few of the examples of which are the important points, like classification, adverse drug reactions, NMR numericals, IR ranges, evaluation parameters like disintegration, dissolution, then calculation schedules from jurisprudence. So these are the topics which are frequently asked in GPAT. So if you will study previous 10-year question papers, you will be able to narrow down which are the important points. So likewise, you have to identify which important points you should study for GPAT. Then moving to next part in what to study is that solve previous year question papers. And it's the most important point, because if you will study at least 10 year ka jo previous paper say start 2020 to 2010, you will be able to narrow down the all the important and frequently asked concepts, and ensure that you will find key those concepts are being repeated and being asked in the GPAT. So in GPAT 2021, there are chances that there will be questions from previous GPAT papers. Example, if you see clinical trial topic in GPAT 14, 16, 17, 18, every year they have tried to ask one question from clinical trials. If you know that clinical trial asked, you will study that clinical trial topic, and you will have an advantage, and you will be confidently mark the correct answer. Similarly, about schedules from jurisprudence. Schedules are the key important topic jurisprudence subject that every year at least one question is there from jurisprudence. For example, in 2016, 2015, 2019, 2020 GPAT, there was question from schedules. So likewise, you have to keep apne ko kaun sa important subject that we have to. The last line mentioned ki sometimes same questions get repeated. Like in our semester's paper also, previous year paper that get repeated at least 50% or 20 to 35% gets repeated in next year semester question. So similarly, GPAT may questions repeat hote hai, questions gets repeated. For example, this was from the last two in GPAT 2020 and GPAT 2019. The same question repeated, just they have reshuffled the. So GPAT 2020 question states that pyrogen present in containers can be destroyed by heating the container at, and the correct answer I have highlighted, 210 degrees Celsius for 4 hours. Same question was asked in the previous year question paper, that is 20. Containers may be rendered free from pyrogen adequate cleaning and by, the same option is there, just they have added one more word, that is heating at 210 degrees Celsius for 3 to 4. Likewise, questions get repeated. So it's better to solve as much as questions and the most important previous year question paper. You will get thorough idea knowledge ki ye question aayega, and you will be confident of concept. This is the key point. Then to our weight distribution for GPAT, since GPAT 20, they have just reshuffled the question paper ka pattern. So from that GPAT 2019, they have allotted few percentage of questions for pharmaceutics syllabus, like in pharmaceutics and its allied subject, physical pharmacy, microbiology, engineering, dispensing. For that, they have allotted 20 to 25%. Similarly, ecology, clinical pharmacy, 20 to 25% of questions. Then 15 to 20% for chemistry part, medicine, chemistry, organic, physical. 10 to 15 for pharmaceutical analysis, and 10 to 15% for pharmacology. Likewise. So why it is important for you from our perspective, if a student is a stronghold in pharmaceutics subjects and it's allied, then he can be sure that yes, any question, if it is asked from the pharmaceutics area, he will solve. So in GPAT, it's important to solve maximum correct answers and minimum getting wrong. Because if you will get wrong, then actually it is really calculate, it becomes -5, because your +4 rehta hai, that also is gone, and -1, so that difference in your ranks and score. So be sure that whenever you solve any question, absolutely sure ki this is the correct answer, tukke baazi, and that rest of thing you should ahead. If there is utmost need ki okay 50-50 ek chance lete, tabhi go for that or else solve jo bhi confidence questions hai that only. Then moving to for final year students who are going to appear for 2021. So this is the list of subjects, important topics, which I have identified from previous 10 year, from after analysis, after doing analysis for previous 10 year question paper. In Cohology, you have to focus on classifications, mechanism of action, DOC, ADR. These four topics, there will be at least 60 questions from Cohology. 10 to 20% will be from different, but these topics will be repeated. Similarly, in medicinal chemistry, SAR, structure synthesis, these three parts you have to do. Similarly, in Sutics, tablets, question aate, capsules, nowadays NDDS, aerosols, emulsions, which are novel formulations, they are trying to ask. Nowadays, ICH guidelines, which of the following ICH, like for Q1 guidelines, states for what, Q2 guidelines, states for what. So that is being also asked in Sutics. So for analysis, there will be question from NMR, IR, numerical, identify how many peaks are present, identify the IR value. In Cognosy, there will be a question, there will be a one question which will state the clinical constituents, clinical chemical constituents, chemical tests, biological source, and its uses, and you have to match the pair. So likewise, questions will be there. So you can take a screenshot of this so that it will be handy for you while using these subjects you have to revise. Then moving to minor subjects like in PPPC, that is physical chemistry, kinetics, micromagnetics, colloids is being repeated. Organic chemistry, stereochemistry reactions, one name reaction will be always asked. Aromaticity, heterocyclic rings in biofarm calculations will be there. Jurisprudence schedules question will be absolutely there. Dispensing pharmacy, postology calculations, allegation method. Similarly, biochemicals, vitamins, which is the location of the Krebs cycle or what is the purpose of the glycolysis, that questions will be there. From microbiology, sterilization, as this is a virus era going on, virus may ask a tech question, microbial ask. So likewise, I have enlisted all the important topics after analyzing the previous 10-year question papers, so which you can revise in December month for revision purpose. Then moving to big books which you can refer. So these are the books which I used to refer my GPAT preparation. All are the reference books, standard reference books, which you should really refer. So for physical pharmacy, Martin is there. Then for pharmaceutics, Alton, Remington, Lachman is there. Then important point where students miss out. Indian pharmacopoeia and US pharmacopoeia is important because whenever you will learn limits, evaluation parameters, microbes, the source of this content is actually the USP. So it's better to know the dissolution parameters, dissolution types, the USP. So go and refer actual source, that is Indian pharmacopoeia and US pharmacopoeia of those concepts. Then moving to dispensing pharmacy, you can refer Dr. Atmaram Pawar's book. Then biopharmaceutics, Brahmankar, ICH guidelines, Cohology, KD Tripathi, Rangandel, Spurge Gupta, Vikas Sheth. Vikas Sheth is a book where you find the classifications for pharmacology. So it is the book which is dedicated for the classification and drug of choice. So you can refer that book. Medicinal chemistry, Foyce, Griswold, Organic Analysis, Park, Cognosy, Kokate, Rangari, so likewise. Then our sir's book, Umang Shah sir's, Pearson, which is ideal book for revision. So as sir has mentioned, it's perfectly, they have highlighted all the bulletin points and important points from every subject. So it's the best book for revision, I will recommend. And for question papers, you can solve Inamdar for previous year question papers. In Inamdar, you will find questions from 19 eras also, for more practice. So this is the entire list of books which you can refer. So this was all about my session. So I thank again Umang Shah sir and Raman Bhai College of Pharmacy for inviting me. I always say that imagine the concepts. Whenever you will start imagining the concepts, you will start understanding those concepts. And whenever you will start understanding those concepts, you should improve daily. And you should make master of most of the topics. So imagine, understand, and improve. So that is the key phenomenon.